Where's the password?
I'm sorry?
The password.
Password?
No, the password.
Password, okay. Well, you can't just go in and have to wait.
Oh, so sorry.
Tell him to come here.
Oh, what?
Bibi. Aka bey daha çok kuruyor.
Bibi.
He's got his, we don't have any money to give him.
Oh, for the buffer.
it's fine. It's fine. It's not going to go away.
I was getting them out of the truck and I said, that's all they have.
Couldn't you notice your bike pickup going to change?
Not really, because I put it on a credit card and the statement hasn't come, so.
But thank you.
I don't want to do it.
I know, and I just thought, okay, I'm gonna just start with a couple things each week and then get away from it and go on to other stuff. You will be. Now, why am I telling you that?
Little yellow and little orange.
Orange is not. Does he have the little white?
Yellow has the white eyes. Orange looks like yellow except for the rest. I've been showing them to all the dog people. You know what they told me? Do you have any
Good morning and welcome to St. James Church.
Morning.
Glad to see you all here today. Today we will have morning prayer led by Beth Carwick and assisted by Debbie Chisholm with a reflection from Debbie Stover. So we're happy to have all of those folks to lead us in worship this morning.
Continue on page 41. Let us humbly confess our sins unto Almighty God.
Lord,
the grace and consolation of his Holy Spirit. Amen. Please turn to page 42. O Lord, open our lips,
and our mouths shall proclaim thy praise.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The Lord is full of compassion and mercy. O come, let us adore him. Please turn to page 44, the Venete. Let us all read in unison Psalm 95, verses 1 through 7. Come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and lay our hearts out to him. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hand are the powers of the earth, and in the heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands the prayer of the dark. Come, let us bow down to him, and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture, and the sheep of his hand. O Lord, today we will be prepared to do his voice.
Do not remember the former things or consider the things of old. I'm about to do a new thing. Now it springs forth. Do you not perceive it? I will make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. The wild animals will honor me, the jackals and the ostriches, for I give water in the wilderness, rivers in the desert, to give drink to my chosen people, the people whom I formed for myself, so that they might declare my praise. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand and turn to page 86. We will recite in unison Canticle 9, the first song of Isaiah. Surely it is God who saves me. I will trust in him and not be afraid. The Lord is my stronghold and my sure defense.
John. 6 days before the Passover, Jesus came to Bethany, the home of Lazarus, whom he had raised from the dead. There they gave a dinner for him. Martha served, and Lazarus was one of those at the table with him. Mary took a pound of costly perfume made of pure nard, anointed Jesus' feet, and wiped them with her hair. The house was filled with the fragrance of the perfume. But Judas Iscariot, one of his disciples, the one who was about to betray him, said, "Why was this perfume not sold for 300 denarii and the money given to the poor?" He said this not because he cared about the poor, but because he was a thief. He kept the common purse and used to steal what was put into it. Jesus said, "Leave her alone. She bought it so that she might keep it for the day of my burial. You always have the poor with you, but you do not always have me." The word of the Lord.
Thinking about what we just read in John and what it, all the things that went on in those 8 verses. And then a couple of weeks ago, we just read about him raising Lazarus from the dead and the Pharisees plotting to kill Jesus. In the gospel reading today that Debbie just read, we have heard Jesus come back to Bethany. He's coming back for dinner in celebration of what he did in chapter 11. And Lazarus was going to be part of that dinner party. And as I was reading the lecture, I thought, oh, you know, I could kind of relate to dinner parties and being able to eat with my friends and be thankful for what Jesus did and having the person that raised me from the dead be there. And then I went to Martha, and Martha was serving. Well, that's the traditional role of the women at that point in time. And I thought, yeah, I'm kind of traditional. You know, although I'm not a good cook, I'm traditional. And then I looked at Mary. Well, Mary did not do anything traditional. She went in for Jesus in a room that traditionally was just men, and they didn't allow, the women weren't supposed to be in there. She went in, she sat at Jesus' feet again. She was very uninhibited, didn't care what people seemed to think about her. And she showed her love to Jesus by taking the oil, the perfume, and opening it up in front of all the men, pouring it on Jesus' feet. And then she took her hair down, something else women didn't do back then in front of men, and wiped his feet clean. And I thought, oh my gosh, is that how uninhibited a person I could be? Could I go out and show my love for Jesus in a way that maybe isn't socially acceptable, but people would see Jesus' love? And then you go on to Judas. Here Judas is, and that could be sold and given to the poor. Well, that's true. But how many times I've been involved with people, and I've said to them, you know, if I were in charge, this is what I would do with this thing and how it done, and it had no effect on me whatsoever. I had no buy-in to what the outcomes were. I didn't have to pay anything, I didn't have to do anything, but this is what somebody else should do. So, you know, I kind of related to every one of those folks in some way or other. And each of them were showing, maybe not Judas, but each of them were showing their love to Jesus in the way that they showed their love to Jesus and the way that they knew him. And today, we are showing our love for Jesus by being here and worshiping. But footnotes in this book, she talks about this story. And it says, it's in all four Gospels. It's a little different in each of the Gospels, but it's in there. And she talks about what it would be like for Mary to walk into this room full of men. She talked about what it would be like for them to smell the perfume in a room full of men, because dinner parties were for men back then. And pour this on Jesus' feet. They, can't you just hear them going on with the men, saying, what is she doing in here? Somebody get rid of her. But she also talked about what that woman would say to us today, after we've been through a pandemic, and after we're coming back to church, what might she say to us today? And I want to read you what she said. You and your church are holding a beautiful jar. You are used to grabbing it with both hands, tilting, pouring the contents with moderation through the carefully crafted spout. Someday you will have to break it open so the contents flow free. Or God will do it for you. You and your church, you think loving things means protecting and maintaining it exactly as it was handed to you. Someday you will understand that it means to love something enough to let it be cracked apart and just sit with the pieces and notice what needs to be removed for good. And then faithfully put the pieces back together with what matters most to make something more whole, something more like what God intended all along. Someday you will lose your life and gain real life. And so we're coming back to church after a pandemic. A long one, feels like to me. And we are back to our worship service like we know and love. Pretty close. We've got a few more things. But anyway, but it feels very comfortable, and I'm grateful for it, and I'm grateful that we can show God's love in this way. But our mission is loving people and serving people. And how we look at our mission today, and the missions we're doing, all show love and service. Are there others? Are there people that we need to connect with differently? I've heard some of the people talk at our truck retreat how many children showed up and were hungry. What do we need to do for them? How do we need to help their families? What's going on? Are we the same church that we were before COVID? I think we've all changed a little bit just because of what's going on. And anytime we see a new member, we change a little bit, because everybody brings in different things and different aspects that they've been through. It can help us learn and see folks. So as we continue with Lent and that, let us prepare our hearts and minds this Lent to focus on our mission of loving people and serving people. Food bags that were up front. Bless these bags of generosity, O Lord, filled with love and kindness of our brothers and sisters throughout the many communities that surround our church. These bags brought forth to your altar exemplify our mission of loving people and serving people. May we always continue to practice the way of the Good Samaritan, and willing to sacrifice and give back to those in need. All of this we ask in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Please stand and turn to page 53. We will recite the Apostles' Creed. God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
We'll read suffrage B on page 98. Save your people, Lord, and bless your inheritance.
Govern and uphold them, now and always.
Day by day we bless you.
We praise your name forever.
Lord, heal us from all sin today.
Have mercy upon us, Lord. Have mercy.
Lord, show us your love and mercy.
For we put our trust in you.
In you, Lord, is our hope.
And we shall never hope in vain.
Let us all pray for the Rector Search Committee. Almighty God, give your remainder your gift, and look graciously on St. James Church, and so guide the minds of those who shall choose a rector for this parish. And we may receive their faithful pastor, who will care for your people, and equip us for our ministries.
I will read the collect for the fifth Sunday in Lent. Almighty God, you alone can bring into order the unruly wills and affections of sinners. Grant your people grace to love what you command and desire what you promise, that among the swift and varied changes of the world, our hearts may surely there be fixed where true joys are to be found. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
We'll read the collect for Sundays on page 56. O God, who makest us glad with the weekly remembrance of the glorious resurrection of thy Son, our Lord, grant us this day such blessing through our worship of thee, that the day is come to may be spent in thy favor, through the same Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
A calling for peace. O God, who art the author of peace and love of concord, in knowledge of whom standeth our eternal life, whose service is perfect freedom, defend us, thy humble servants, and all the assaults of our enemies, that we, surely trusting in thy defense, may not fear the power of any adversaries, through the might of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Collect for guidance. O Heavenly Father, in whom we live
him on page 59. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as they are best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen.
Thank you.
Beth and both Debbies appreciate the morning prayer this morning. Just a reminder that our Lenten program, this is the last Wednesday, we'll do Stations of the Cross at 6, and the program led by Joe John and Mike Evans, Owens, sorry, Mike, the 12 Apostles at 6:30. There will be a Zoom link for those who can't attend. It's been a very wonderful program, so I highly recommend it, and I'm trying to convince Mike and Joe to take it for all of us that weren't able to be there. For those that came Friday night, I appreciate you. We had our pasta, our second pasta dinner, thanks to Pam and Eric Martin and Beth and Corky Webb for putting that on for us. Food was wonderful. There is pasta and marinara sauce in the kitchen if anybody would like to take some home. The pasta is actually frozen in individual bags. It's an individual serving. All you do is plop it in boiling water for about 10 seconds and it's good to go. The marinara sauce is in a bag. For those that have not seen, St. James lost a very important person in our parish life, Tom Saban, this past week. The arrangements for that is we'll have a visitation here at church from 11:30 to 1 in Gleason Hall. The service will be at 1 here, and then there'll be a burial right afterwards in our cemetery, and a light reception following the burial. Keep Sherry and all the family in your hearts and in your prayers. We are going to be making palm crosses and cleaning the brass and the silver next Saturday from 10 to 12:30. If you can come out and help, if you have any questions, contact Rita, but we can use the help. We are having an Easter egg hunt this year, so we need Easter candy. If you can bring it up to the church between now and the 15th, we'd appreciate it. Individually wrapped so that it'll fit in plastic eggs. We hope to have lots of kids on Easter Sunday, so we need lots of candy. Anybody has any fresh flowers that they'd like to donate to decorate our windows in the church for Easter Sunday, please make sure you get that. Rita will give you all the information you need for that. Our Holy Week schedule is in our e-blast and anywhere else you can think to find it, so be sure to keep an eye on that. There's a lot going on. We have something every day of Holy Week. Thanks to everybody who brought up your food bags. If you forgot it this morning, you can bring it to the office tomorrow between 9 and 1. The healing blankets will have their next selling date on the 25th at 9:30 in the Undercroft, so you're more than welcome to that. We're having a blood drive on the 27th from 2 to 7. They prefer having appointments. You can sign up online or you can do a walk-in. Just an information for those who are interested, the Diocesan Summer Camp is going to be happening again this year. There's information on that in our e-blast as well as on the Diocesan website. So it's great that we're getting back to at least a good semblance of normalcy at this point. Now for the fun announcements, the last announcement and the funnest announcement. For those of you who have not heard, although I don't know how because we've blasted it out to the world, our animal care ministry is naming a litter of 12 puppies, and we had everybody put in suggestions for names, and now we're voting for those names. We're going to be picking the names today, well, assigning the names to the puppies today, but we need everybody to vote on the names. Everything's in the back. It's $1 a vote. Please, if you forgot your money, you can get it into us. Just give us your vote so that we can pick our 12. And like I said, we'll be doing that today after church, so we need the votes this morning. I hope everybody has a very blessed day. Thank you all.
Such a good job. He's going to be the next Virgil at some point.
he might be very good at that, although he did look a little uncertain coming back.
So curious, I told you I didn't have a songbook up there, so I wasn't sure how many books I had. Turn the place on, so I was kind of walking through the place, and I was like, oh, because you're still holding the book. But the other, the Book of Common Prayer up there was